Hey guys, today we are going to discuss about the abnormal splitting of second heart song. So, for understand of abnormal splitting of the second heart song, we should know that where's the radius of the second heart song. Here is the left side of the heart and here the right side of the heart. When the blood enters from the left atrium to left ventricle, and when high concentration of the blood in the heart left ventricle, the same mechanism is going into the right side. So I will describe here the left side. Blood will enter into the left ventricle from the left atrium. At that time, due to the high concentration of the blood into the left ventricle, the blood slightly move back, and at that time this valve will close. In the left side, the name of this valve is the bicuspid valve or mitral valve. And already I have said that the same mechanism is going to the right side of the heart, mean that when the blood will enter from the right atrium to right ventricle, and due to the high concentration into the right ventricle, it will move back slightly and this valve will be closed, and then the name of this valve is a tricuspid valve. And here produce a first heart sound. But when due to the high concentration and the contraction of the ventricle into the left side and the right side, the blood will move from the ventricle into the right side into the pulmonary vessels and into the left side into the aorta. But due to entry to the aorta and the pulmonary vessel, there's also present a valve whose name is a aortic valve in the left side and the pulmonary valve on the right side. The both the valve name is the semilunar valve. And the main problem in the second heart sound mean that there's because when the blood will enter into the vessel through the right ventricle or the left ventricle, the slightly it will move back, and at that time the aortic valve or the pulmonary valve will be closed. Aortic valve on the left side and the pulmonary valve on the right side, this will close, and at that time the second heart sound is produced, mean that S2, and the splitting, abnormal splitting of the second heart sound mean that there is a problem in the second heart sound. And first of all we will discuss about the widening of the splitting. In the normal person, due to the inspiration, the second heart sound takes some time because there is the gaseous exchange occur, and then the second heart sound produced. So it takes a time little bit in the lap and dub. But when there is a problem, first of all we will discuss about the widening of the split. In the widening of the split, the expiration is the normal, and here is the S1 mean the first heart sound, and A2 is the aortic valve or the, and P2 is the pulmonary valve, aortic valve and the pulmonary valve. And here there is a problem. This is a normal in the expiration, the lesser widening. This is the lesser widening, but during the inspiration we can see there is a less widening, but during the inspiration the widening is more. Why the widening is the more? The reason is this, that the maybe due to the pulmonary valve stenosis, or maybe to the right bundle branches are not working properly, mean that the conduction system is not working properly, or when there is a stenosis in the pulmonary valve, then the closing of this not properly occur, and this takes some time. So in the production of the second heart sound, there's also takes some time, and this is known as a widening of the split. And if in the exam someone asks you a question that if there is a problem into the pulmonary valve or the right side of the heart, then which splitting will be occurred, we can say that there will be a widening of the splitting. So the next one is that the fixed splitting. Fixed splitting means that there is no problem into the aortic wall or the pulmonary wall. The aortic and the pulmonary wall are the both wall are the same and accurately they are closing at the same time. But the problem is that there is a problem in the septum. What's the septum? Septum is the line or the border which separates the right side of the heart into from the left side of the heart, and there is a defect in the septum, then the shunt will be produced. Where's the shunt will be produced? From where side? The shunt will produce from the left side of the heart to the right side of the heart. What's the reason that the shunt is going to produce from the left side of the heart to the right side of the heart? The reason is this, because in the left side of the heart, the pressure of the blood is a high. The pressure of the blood is a high, so that the shunt from the left side to the right side, and the, in the left side there's the concentration of the oxygenated blood is high, mean that the concentration of the oxygen is high, and at the right side the concentration of the carbon dioxide is high, mean that in the right side is present of the deoxygenated blood. But due to the shunt of the left to right, the oxygenated blood will mix into the deoxygenated blood, and this is known as a septal defect. Due to septal defect, there's no defect in the wall, there's a defect only into the septum. When the septum is not fully developed, then the shunt from the left to right, and this is very important MCQ. In the adult, the shunt will be from left to right. The shunt will be from left to right because there the concentration and the value and the pressure of the left side of the heart is a high, and due to the high pressure the blood will move from the left to right. And this is also a very important MCQ that after a birth, within a few days, the shunt will be from the right to high. The right to high because there is a supply through the umbilical cord or the umbilical vein, so that the from the right side of the heart or the right atrium, the blood enter into the left atrium because there is a high concentration and pressure in the right side. Mean that if someone asks you a question in the exam, that a person who is adult, which type of the shunt? There is a shunt of the left to right. And if someone asks you a question that there is a baby as a few days after a delivery, the shunt will be right to left. And the third one is a paradoxical splitting. What's the mean of the paradoxical splitting? The mean is this, that there is a problem in the aortic stenosis. This is present of the aortic wall, and the stenosis means the stenosis, it is not closing properly. The closing is not properly. Due to the not closing properly, the left ventricle, the blood can't properly move from the ventricle into aorta, and also it's due to the not properly working of the left bundle branches. When the left ventricle bundle branches will not working properly, and due to the aortic stenosis, the blood not properly move out from the ventricle to the aorta. So this produce of the second heart sound late after some time, but sometimes this produce at the same time, lub and dub, like that, lub and dub. Means same time, you if you auscultate with the stethoscope, you will listen that lub and dub like this. But here you will listen a song lub trup, mean that it takes some time. Here due to less widening, it's the lub trup. But here due to the more widening, this you can listen a sound, mean that you can increase the lub trup in the auscultation, in the stethoscope. So this was all about the abnormal splitting of the second heart sound.